Hello everybody and welcome back, and let us continue with our Meterpreter session. So, in the previous video we were able to deliver the payload to the victim PC, which is my Windows 10 PC, and we were also able to run it and connect back to our PC. So right now we have Meterpreter session opened. Now let us see what we can do with some of the basic commands that we can get from the help command. Later on we will run some modules, but for now on let us just see what we have currently. So just type here help and let us see what does it offer us. So let us start from the beginning. So here it is. We can background the session. Now this is also an important command. For example, if you there are two commands, one of them will exit you out of this session, you will not be able to connect back, and one of them will just put the session in the background. Now if you type here exit, this will exit the Meterpreter session and you will not be able to connect back to the victim PC, but if you just type here background, it will prompt you with your Metasploit command line once again, and it will not close the session. As we can see, it will only put it in background. So if I clear the screen and just type here sessions once again, you will see that we still have the session open, and whenever we want we can just go sessions minus I and then the ID of the session, which is 1, and then we enter the Meterpreter once again. So that is also something that you should know. Let us see what else does it give us that is useful. So for example, let me just see right here, there is the command terminate the Meterpreter session, which is exit, get the session ID, machine ID, you can just run that, migrate, pivot. Now basically machine ID, if you just type it right here, so machine underscore ID is basically nothing really useful to us, but there is an option for some reason for that. This is basically a session, so we saw how we can run that, run use. So these are commands that are not really for the Meterpreter itself. These are basically some of the Metasploit commands. What we are mostly interested in are these commands right here. So as we can see, this is basically the same commands almost as in Linux. So we can navigate through the victim PC with these commands. We can upload files, we can download files, we can copy the files, we can run other files, we can also, for example, run a notepad from our Meterpreter shell. Not really something useful, but it is something we can do. We can list working directory, we can change directory, we can... So let's do some of that. So dir, if you just type here dir, which is the command for the Windows command prompt in order to list all of the files in the current directory, we will see the files from my desktop, since if I type here pwd, I'm currently in my desktop folder, since my file that we ran is on my desktop. And if I list all of the files, I will see these files right here. As we can see, these are the same files. Now, dir command, you can use that one or you can use ls. Now, it is the same. One of them is for the Windows as a Windows command. So dir is used in command prompt in Windows and ls is used in the Linux. The Meterpreter session gives us both options to use. Now, you can change directory. So as I showed you, if I type pwd, I'm currently in my desktop directory, and if I go one directory back, you will see that I'm not really anymore in the desktop directory. If I type here dir once again, you will see other files right here. So what we want to do is basically cd back to our desktop, pwd and ls. So we have these files right here. Now, if I wanted to, I could, for example, download any of these files with the download command. So let's see if there is anything we can do. Well, there really isn't, but what we can do is make directories. So mkdir, and if I show you the desktop, first of all, you will see that there is no test directory right here. But if I just type here mkdir creating directory test, and if I go right down here, you will see that now we successfully created a folder called test. And now if we want to, we can change our directory to that folder, pwd, and we can see that we are now in the test directory. So we can also create folders, download folders, create files, and so on and so on. If we wanted to, you could also cat a file, for which is useful. For example, if a victim has some file where it stores some information or something like that, you can cat it and read the content of that file. But let us see what else we can do instead of actually navigating through the system, since that is what we already know. or basically if you just do not know, you can just read all of these commands, so cd, change directory, cp, and upload, download, which is useful command, so upload a file or directory. You will need to specify which file or directory you want to upload, and download, you will need to specify which download directory you want to download. So let's see lower what we have right here, which are the networking commands. So what we want to do, we can actually change the, or not change, we can actually check the IP config, netstat, so basically anything that we ran in our terminal, in our Linux, we can also check in Windows. So let us see, if I just type here ifconfig, as I showed you before, it will give us our IP address. Now, both in the Meterpreter, both commands ifconfig and ipconfig will work. So if I just type here ipconfig, it will print out the same output. Basically, it is the same as with the dir and ls commands. So they support, the Meterpreter shell supports both Linux and Windows terms. If you just type here arp, it will print out the arp cache. And if you just type here netstat, for example, -nr, it will give us the netstat connections and all the processes running. So let me just see right here. As we can see, all the established connections, which there is a lot of them, and here is our file. So this is established connection to us, as we can see right here. Our Windows 10 machine connected to the 192.168.1.4 on port 4444, which is our Kali Linux machine. So if I just type here help, in order to see some of the other commands. So we check these ones, we check these ones, we check these ones. So basically you can check all the other networking commands as well. As we can see, route, view and modify the routing table, which could be interesting. Port forward, forward the local port to a remote servers, which you can use in order to create basically a port forwarding rule on the Windows 10 machine, which basically could allow you to connect more easily next time. But we will not be needing that at the moment. What we want to do is basically check out the lower options as well. So here, as we can see, the shutdown reboot command, which will restart the victim PC. The shutdown command will shut down the victim PC. Now, I will not be running any of those two commands, since if I shut down my Windows 10 PC, I also shut down the recording and my Kali Linux machine, which would make zero sense. So really no point in doing that. I will show you those commands once we attack the Windows 7 with Eternal Blue. But for now on, let us see some of the other commands. So let's, for example, check out the ps, which is the command to list all the running processes, which could be useful. So we can just type here ps and it will give us all of the processes currently running in the machine. So in the Windows 10 machine, let me just zoom out a little bit so it gets a better printout. So we can see our process is right here. So here it is, the NVIDIA container, this one. So this is the process of our shell. Now, for example, if our victim notices something fishy, they can actually find out the process and they can close the process with task managers. For example, if they just open task manager, and see that they ran a file called shell.txt, they'll most likely try to close it, which really they cannot do while the process is running. Let me just show you. If I just lower this and lower the task manager, if I click right here and click on the delete button, you will see the action can't be completed because the file is open in shell.txt. Now, most of the people that are not interested in technology and that don't know much about computers won't really know how to close this, but those who have a little bit of knowledge can just go to the task manager and just find the shell.txt, here it is, right click and then end task, but we will not do it yet. So we will show, I will show you in the next videos how you can actually, let me just make this larger, how you can actually create persistent and copy the file itself into a new directory in order for you to have a full-time access to this PC, so every time it boots up, every time it connects to the internet, you will get a connection back. So that is one of the most useful things that we will also show right here, but for now on, let us see what else we can run. So help command, we go right here. There are a bunch of these other options that you can use if you want to, you can check what they do. such as, for example, clear event log. Now we need to have administrative privileges for this, which I will also show you how you can get administrative privileges on any Windows machine. You can drop token, execute a command, get environment, so also you can, which is could be useful, enter into shell. So basically, once you type here shell, it will basically just open up a command prompt for the victim PC. As we can see now, it is the same as if we were to run the command prompt. It looks exactly the same, the output of the command is the same. Basically not really much use of this, but if you simply find it easier to use a command prompt than the Meterpreter shell, you can do that as well. In order to exit the shell, you just type here exit. This will only exit the shell itself, it will not exit the Meterpreter shell. So don't type here exit twice or you will be exiting the Meterpreter shell. So let's see what else we can do. There are a bunch of these options for the, let me just find it right here. You can terminate the processes, you can filter processes by name, so basically you can run anything you want. Now the user interface commands, which are down here, we will cover in the next video, such as, for example, recording microphone, screenshotting, starting a keylogger, and these other commands that could be actually very interesting to us. So I will see you in the part 2 of this tutorial, where we cover the basic Meterpreter commands. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope I see you in the next one. Bye!